Hello everyone, I am Mark Denzel B. Tobias from BSEd 4B Science. And today, I will discuss the teacher and the learning process. So from the definition of the teacher and the learning process, the teacher is someone who causes others to learn. He is a person who exerts influence in the life of other people, specifically the children under his care, which is very true. So from the definition, the teacher is indeed the backbone of the future and the pillars of education. So there are 8 roles of a teacher. These are model, classroom manager, facilitator of learning, motivator, evaluator of students' performance, parent surrogate, counselor, and a friend. So based from this role, this is the responsibility of the teacher to embody these roles and inside the classroom in order to have a peaceful and classroom management wherein the students can learn in a child-friendly classroom. So moving on, we have here the qualities of an effective teacher. From the word kashe, the letter K stands for knowledge. The letter A stands for attitude. The letter S stands for skills. Letter H, habits. Letter E, experience. And also we have here the intelligence, good health, self-confidence, affability or friendliness, consideration for others, educationally qualified, and morally strong. So these are the qualities or traits that the teacher must embody sa kanyang mga students para magkaroon ng good relationship between students' learning and the teacher's teaching. That's all. So there are 5 needs of a teacher. The first one is fair treatment. The second one, firmness and understanding from their superiors. Third one, positive atmosphere. Fourth is recognition for their contribution, and 5, chance for professional growth. So these things or these needs is a must for a teacher, because without these needs is hindi po magka-function ng mabuti ang isang teacher. Kaya kailangan ng mga teacher ang 5 needs na ito. So next, there are 10 things to be a good teacher. So the first one is, keeps in contact with the parents of his or her pupils and lets them participate in the life of the school in a primary or secondary school. The second is, able to maintain discipline and order. Next, number 3, let the students share his or own or her own life with all its up and down. 4, works hard to remain up to date in his or her subject. And number 5, openly admits when he or she has made a mistake or does not know something. And number 6, the good teacher is interested in his or her students, ask them about their homes, and try to help where possible. And number 7, makes the student work hard and set high standards. Number 8, is friendly and helpful to his or her colleagues. And for number 9, a good teacher uses a lot of different materials, equipment, and teaching methods and attempts to make his or her lessons interesting. And lastly, a good teacher helps the students become independent and organize their own learning. So those things are the ways to be a good teacher. So there are 5 forms of teacher power. So the first power of a teacher is attractive or referent power. So when we say attractive, the teacher is pleasing, such as being likable, funny, or charming. Okay, number 2, the expert power. expert power, the students felt there was a great deal of value. So the teacher must be knowledgeable in his or her subject matter. And number three, reward power. For reward power, it includes grades, recognition, prizes, and praise to the students who accomplish very well the task. Next is coercive power. So if a line is crossed, something will happen that will be less desirable for the students than if they choose not to cross the line. So the teacher here has the power to say no or to give punishment or consequences to the students if the students cross the line. Next, for position or legitimate power. So the teacher, in addition to their roles as educator, is sanction authority in the room. So the teacher has the authority inside the classroom to ask the students or to tell the students what to do inside the classroom. So as a teacher, he or she needs to have a good classroom management. So what is classroom management? So classroom management, as defined by Good 1959, is the administration or direction with special reference to problems involving discipline, democratic techniques, use of supplies and other materials, the physical features of the classroom, general of activities, housekeeping, and the social relationships, the operation and control of classroom activities of the pupils and teachers. It can be summarized as the operation and control of classroom activities. So classroom management, in other words, is the operation and control inside the classroom for have a proper peace and order classroom. So in doing classroom roles, we have here the five principle. So the first one is the teacher should plan activities that are suited to the classroom conditions. The second one, the teacher should plan activities that are suited to the classroom conditions. The third one, the teachers must observe some routinary procedures to save the energy. Say, for example, entering and leaving the room, passing of papers, etc. And number four, the teachers must take into consideration the needs and conditions of their students. And lastly, the teacher must utilize positive rather than negative approach in dealing with children. So as a teacher, we should know this principle in order to have a proper classroom management. So we will going to have a classroom rules in order for the students to follow and to have a proper guidance in throughout there. So inside the classroom, so there are causes of disciplinary problems in the classroom. So we have five. So the first one is the teacher's personality. So the teacher lacks of knowledge of the subject matter for decision making, which can lead to a problem. The students will not learn effectively. The second one is physical factors. So the health conditions of the child. When we are talking about the children, we must ensure their safety and their health. So if they are not healthy, they will not learn effectively. The third one is the individual factors, individual differences due to the family and community background. So dito na po mapasok yung discrimination and everything. So everything must ensure the proper classroom management for have a good peace and order classroom. So number four, we have here the social factors adjustment to the group. So everyone comes from a diverse places. So the students is also diverse. So they have different learning style, they come from different ethnicity. So everything as a teacher should implement a good classroom rules in order for the students to have to be knowledgeable and to be aware in terms of social adjustments. And number five, so when we say emotional factors, everyone, every student has its own emotional thinking. So in order for this to solve is to have a respect and understanding in every student. The teacher must always allow the openness to each other. So in addition for causes of disciplinary problems in the classroom, we have here the school environment. So isa pong factor ang school environment to have a problem inside the classroom. So para hindi po magkaroon ng problema, we should always promote a child-friendly environment in order to have a peace and order in every students and to the communications in everyone as well. Regardless of their gender, regardless of their race, and regardless kung saan man sila nang galing. So next, in every problems, there is always a solution. So here are the seven ways to improve classroom discipline. So the first one is to know your subject matter and be prepared at all times. Number two, come to class ahead of your students. Number three, call the class to order as soon as the bell rings. And number four, follow some established daily routine. Number five, check the condition of the class as well as the condition of every pupil. Number six, compliment your students on worthy contributions. And number seven, always consider individual differences in dealing with your pupils. So these are the ways to improve a classroom discipline to have a peace and order inside the classroom. Okay, thank you for listening, everyone. So I have prepared here 5 multiple choice quiz for you to answer. Take time and have a good day, everyone. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.